Hello, good afternoon. Today's topic is, my name is Sheikh Ismail Ali Basha, Department of Botany. Today discuss about Unit 3, Fungi and Algae. Right? Fungi are eukaryotic organisms that includes microorganisms such as yeast, molds and mushrooms. These organisms are classified under the kingdom Fungi. The organisms found in kingdom Fungi contain a cell wall and are omnipresent. They are classified as heterotrophs among the living organisms. Right. Next, characteristics of fungi. Fungi are eukaryotic, non-vascular, non-motile and heterotrophic organisms. They may be unicellular or filamentous. They reproduced by means of spores. Fungi exhibits the phenomena of alternation of generation. Fungi lack chlorophyll and hence cannot perform the photosynthesis. Fungi store their food in the form of a starch. Biosynthesis of a chitin occurs in fungi. The nucleus of the fungi are very small. The fungi have no embryonic stage. They develop from the spores. The mode of reproduction is sexual or asexual. Some fungi are parasitic and can infect the host. Example, mushrooms, molds and yeasts. Right. This is the Ainsworth classification of fungi. The Ainsworth scientist, he was proposed to two types of fungi. Myxomycota and Eumycota. The Myxomycota further divided into four classes. Acrasiomycetes, Hydromyxomycetes, Myxomycetes, Plasmodiophoromycetes and Eumycota, five divisions. Masticomycotina, Zygomycotina, Ascomycotina, Basidiomycotina, Deuteromycotina. It is the Ainsworth classification of the fungi kingdom. Next one is, the next topic is Rhizophus. Rhizophus is a type of fungus that belonging to the class Zygomycetes. As it is, species produces zygospores in the sexual reproductive phase. They are also called breadcrumb, block or a pin mold. It is rhizophorous structure. The rhizophore consists of two kinds of hyphae, namely vegetative and reproductive hyphae. Vegetative hyphae differentiate into two types, namely stolen on rhizoids, and the reproductive hyphae turn into sporangiophores. The reproduction of rhizophus, it reproduces by the vegetative and asexual and sexual methods. Vegetative reproduction is rhizophus. Sometimes the thallus of the rhizophus breaks accidentally or due to some other factors into the few fragments, after which each fragment gives rise to a new thallus on favorable condition. The next one is the asexual reproduction in rhizophus. The asexual reproduction can take place through both sporangiospores and chalcedospores. Next one is the sexual reproduction in rhizophus. In rhizophus, sexual reproduction occurs by the methods of a gametangential conjugation. Right. Next one is rhizophore after Puccinia. Puccinia is a very large genus with about 1800 species distribution in all parts of the world. The genus is represented by more than 147 species, which causes serious rust disease in cereal crops like wheat, barley, oats and maize. The species of Puccinia are internal obligate parasites. Only spores are seen on the host surface. Pieces of Puccinia are either autoecious, means a complete life cycle on a single host, or heterocious, they complete life cycle on two different hosts. The structure of the Puccinia. The mycelium is dikaryotic, means each cell of the mycelium bears two nuclei. On primary host, and monokaryotic, means each cells of the mycelium bears only one nucleus on the secondary or alternate host. The monokaryotic mycelium is also called Hapiomycelium or primary hyphae, and the dikaryotic mycelium is called a secondary hyphae. The mycelium is well developed, branched, separated and does not spread throughout the host, but is localized to isolated patches. The life cycle of Puccinia gramineus. The Puccinia gramineus is a long cycle rust. At the time of a reproduction, it produces 5 distinct stages in regular sequence. Stage 0, the Sermogonia bearing spermatia on receptive hyphae. Stage 1, Aesia bearing aesiospores. Stage 2, Uridia bearing uridiospores. Stage 3, Tilia bearing tiliotospores. Stage 4, Promomycelia bearing basidiospores. Out of these 5 stages, uridostages and tiliotostage are produced on the primary host, and remaining 2 stages are produced on the secondary host. Example ko barberry. The life cycle show the Puccinia, like acidiospores produce uridia on a leaf, tilia on the leaves. After tiliospores released in spring season, the Puccinia on tiliotectum, the Puccinospores are released after they grow into the new Puccinia plants. Now, economic uses of fungi. The fungi in medicine, like a fungi plays an essential role in the production of medicines and is very helpful to cure various health issues. Some of the commonly used fungi is included. The first one is that the antibiotic penicillium is produced from the fungi penicillium. Micafungina is used as an antifungal agent. Next one is the fungi in agriculture. Fungi has the ability to decompose the organic matter in the soil, which leads to the increase in the nutritional quality. They decreases the amount of nitrogen in the soil by converting it to the protein for plants. The fungi form a symbiotic relationship with plants known as a mycorrhiza, through which plants obtain phosphorus and other essential minerals. The fungi produce various bioactive metabolites, which help in the improvement of the plant growth. Right, the fungi in agriculture, fungi are important for the agriculture and they are responsible for the decomposition of organic matter in the soil, release of oxygen, nitrogen, carbon and phosphorus in the soil, production of different enzymes in the soil, enhancement of plant growth, prevent plants from the different pathogens. It is a fungi in agriculture. The symptoms of plant disease caused by the fungi. A symptoms of plant disease is a visible effect of a disease on the plant. Symptoms may include a detectable change in color, shape or function of the plant as it respond to the pathogen. Leaf wilting is a typical symptoms of verticillium wilt caused by the fungal plant pathogen. Verticillium albopictus and Verticillium dahliae. The common bacteria blight symptoms includes brown necrotic lesions surrounded by the bright yellow halo at the leaf margin or interior of the leaf on bean plants. You are not actually seeing the disease pathogen, but rather a symptoms that is being caused by the pathogen. The fungal disease symptoms, the bird's eye spot on berries, dumping of a seedling, leaf spots, chlorosis. It is the fungal disease symptoms. The next two diseases is the blast of rice. Rice blast caused by the fungus Magnophorte oryzae is generally considered the most important disease of the rice worldwide because of its extensive distribution and destructiveness under favorable condition. This blast of rice symptoms can be either lesions or spots. Their shape, color and size vary depending upon the variety resistance, environmental condition on the age of the lesions. The pathogen infects and produces lesions on the following parts of the rice plant: leaf, leaf collar, comb, comb nodes and panicle. The next one is the topic is lichens. Lichens are a dual organisms or entities which contain a permanent association of a fungus or mycobiont and alga or phycobiont. The fungal partner is usually in Ascomycota and sometimes a Basidiomycetae. The algal partner is mostly a green alga or a cyanobacterium. Next one is the structure of lichens. The structure is a three part: crustos, foliage, fruticos. The first one is crustos. Crust like a closely appressed to the substratum and attached to it in several places. The examples are Graphis, Lecanora, Rhizocarpon. Next stage is foliage. The body of the lichen is a flat, broad-edged, lobed and leaf-like which attach to the substratum at one or a few places. Example को Parmelia, Peltigra. Next one is fruticose. The lichen is a branch like a bush attached to the substratum by means of disc. Example को Cladonia, Usienia, Evernia. The rate of reproduction of lichens. The progressive death and decay resulting in the separation of a lichens into two or more parts. The fragmentation caused by the mechanical injury due to wind, trampling or animal bites. Insidia are superficial outgrowths of the lichens, which are primarily meant for the increasing surface area and photosynthetic activity. At times, they are a broken off. Each Insidium is capable of forming a new lichen because it has a core of algal cells surrounded by a sheath of the fungal hyphae. Soridia, they are microscopic lichens, propagules which are producing large number inside sori called a pustulas. Soridia are dispersed by air currents after falling on a suitable substratum, which Soridium gives rise to the lichens. Because it has a few algal cells surrounded the incompletely by a weft of fungus. Economic importance of lichens. Lichens used to the use as a fooder, medicinal uses, industrial uses. These are the economic importance of lichens. Use as a food. In Tamil Nadu, a species of Parmelia known in Telugu as a ratapu or rock flower has been used in curry preparation and is famous for the delicacy. It is also used for the preparation of chocolates and pastries. Next one, used as a fooder. Caledonia rangifera, commonly known as reindeer moss, grow in a dense tuft of the up to 12 inches height in extremely cold regions. It is food for the reindeer and cattle. The species of Caledonia, Citraria, Evernia, Parmelia are used as a fooder. The next two uses to medicinal uses. Eucinic acid obtained from the Eucinia and Caledonia species is used as an antibiotic against gram-positive bacteria. Plitigra canina, the dark lichen, is used as a medicine for the hydrophobia in ancient days. Next uses the industrial uses. The lungwort lichen is used as a tanning in perfumery. In Russia and Sweden, lichens are used for the production of the alcohol. Next one is the ecological importance of lichens. That is the economic importance, it is a ecological importance, right? The lichens contribute to the soil formation. Lichens thrive the undisturbed sites where nothing else will grow. They grow on rocks, boring soil, on the bark of dead or live trees. They are not parasitic. When they are grow on trees, they just use the tree bark as a home. Lichens fix nitrogen. Due to their association with the algae, they are able to convert the nitrogen in the air into the nitrates, which they need for their growth. Conversion of the atmospheric nitrogen impacts the ecosystem because when it rains, nitrates are leached from the lichens for use by nearby soil-based plants. Thus, they make the soil fertile. Right, lichens need a clean air. Although the ant can survive in the extreme climates, including extreme heat, cold, and droughts, they are sensitive to the air pollution. Because they are so pollution sensitive, some scientists use them to assess the air pollution coming from industrial plants and urban areas. And next one, they absorb everything from the air, including the carbon dioxide and heavy metals. The scientists can extract toxic components from the lichens and determine the level of air pollution in given area. The dying of lichen at a site in a early warning sign of a harmful pollution. Right? It is the algae and fungi problem. Right? Okay, thank you.